احنا النهارده قدام دير سانت كاترين رمز السماحه والاديان والقدسيه. النهارده زي ما انتم شايفين وهتشوفوا معانا النهارده الدير موجود كنيسه من اقدم الكنائس في العالم، وعندنا جامع موجود جوه اللي بناه الحاكم بامر الله في مكان للصلاه بتاع الاخوه اليهود في جبل موسى. النهارده مكان دوت من اجمل اماكن العالم، هو رمز للسلام والتسامح بين الاديان الثلاثه. تعالوا نشوف، هنحاول نشوف ونزور الدير من الداخل. Hello, Father Justin. We are very happy that we are here at the monastery in Saint Catherine, and we need to say Happy Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. And we need some information and how they live, the people here, about the visitors, and general information to let the people. Can have some knowledge, some information about the holy place.
This is a holy place because it is the place where God spoke to the prophet Moses first, and then the prophet Elijah came here.
Yes.
When Christians first came here at the end of the third and the beginning of the fourth century, they wanted to find the place where the prophets had come, where God had revealed himself in such a special way. So this has been a place where people dedicate themselves to spiritual goals for 1,700 years. The oldest continuously occupied monastery in the world. It used to take 10 days on a camel to reach the monastery. You had to come down from Suez.
Ah, from Suez by camel.
And it took 10 days to get here.
To get here.
So in some days, in some years, we had 30 people visiting the monastery in the whole year. But now we have roads, we have hotels, we have shops, restaurants in the whole area to support people who want to visit the monastery. And especially in the winter time when it is so cold in Russia and Europe, many people come here from all over the world. And some days we have 1,000 people here every day.
Yes, so 1,000 wow. people per day.
So it is one of the most important visitors' sites in all of Egypt.
So, Your Holiness, what can you tell us about the upgrades and evolution in the architecture of the monastery?
We know that when the monks first settled in the area, they had one humble chapel at the place of the burning bush. And they also had a tower where they could hide in case of an attack, because this was open, not protected. So that's what it was like in the fourth century. At the middle of the sixth century, the Emperor Justinian ordered the construction of the great basilica that is in the middle of the church and the high surrounding walls. So in the sixth century, this was transformed from a small chapel where people gathered for prayers, living in the whole area, to the great central monastery that we have today. And the amazing thing is that it has survived from the sixth century to the present day.
Father, if you can tell us also, I need some information about the holy tree here, and there is some very important icon. concerning the history of the monastery?
We know that Moses grew up in the palace of Pharaoh, and then he left here for the desert.
Yes.
He had lived here for 40 years.
Yes.
And then he saw a bush that was burning, but the flames were not consuming the bush. And this was very strange. This was against nature. So he drew near to see what this strange sight was. And that is when God spoke to him through this burning bush and commanded him to return to Egypt and bring the children of Israel here. So it is that first revelation of God at the burning bush that is the place of the monastery here. And the burning bush grows to this day behind the church.
So, sir, what can you say about the needs of the monastery? Do you have anything concerning the government that you need from the government, or anything you need from Egypt to facilitate your life and for the other monks?
One of the most striking things about the monastery is that it has been a Greek Orthodox monastery from the 4th century, but it has also been a place from the 7th century of peace between Christians and Muslims. The Bedouin in the area traced their descent to the soldiers who built the monastery in the 6th century. And then with the coming of Islam, they became Muslims. But Sinai has been a place of peace and harmony between Christians and Muslims. And we have a mosque inside the monastery.
Yes, I saw the mosque now.
And the bell tower and the minaret standing next to each other are symbols of this peace and harmony that has existed here. We could not do everything that we need to do without the support of the Bedouin.
This is message for all the world, you know, for everybody all over the world.
Message of peace.
This is message of peace.
That is one of the things the Archbishop has said, that this is the lesson that Sinai has to teach the world. You can have fervent Christians and you can have fervent Muslims, but they can live together in harmony.
Thank you for your time. Thank you for...
You're welcome to come here.
Let us to come inside.
If you have the time, we can go and show you one of the services that we have in our church.
Yeah.
Thank you, Father.
Sure, we can do that. Okay.